So while we are looking at the power delivered by 50 volt source, we should understand that can be found out by the mesh analysis or the node analysis or NAF, the source transformation. There are three methods now. We have learned source, we have learned mesh analysis and node analysis. Now we are learning source transformation. Okay, so source transformation is another method of analyzing the electrical circuits. Fine. So you have to be very particular when we are dealing with the questions that is asked in module one. We have to be very particular about the method that they ask us to deal with. Okay, so this problem can be solved in many ways. Okay, so the type, the method that they have asked us to solve this problem is by source transformation. Understand that? Okay, so let's solve this problem by rewriting the circuit in the required form. Okay, what is that? Rewrite the circuit as following. So how I can rewrite this? Everybody look at this. These lines are there, right? Which are leaning, which are slant. Let's write them as vertical lines. Okay, so we're not good. We are not used to this. Rather, we are good, but we are not used to such lines. So let us write them in the normal method. Okay, so what is that? So let's do that here. Everybody, just copy it down fast. Okay. This is how the circuit is going to look like in usual way, but it is given in a different way, which we are not very comfortable with. Okay, so it is just this circuit. So if you can write it like this, it would help you. There is no need that we have to be writing it like this. We can just move ahead with the given circuit itself. Okay, so if you want, you can take it in this form, because this is going to help you. Fine. Now, what they have asked us is to find out the power delivered by 50 volt source. So let's remember, everybody just remember this. When we are asked to find out the power delivered by 50 volt source, we are not supposed to lose this 50 volt source. Everybody is okay with that? Okay, when we are asked to find out the power delivered by 50 volt source. Okay, what is that? We have to be understanding what is the node. Don't lose 50 volt source. So this you need to remember. We are not losing this 50 volt. So we are not losing this 50 volt source means we are not transforming this. So you can think of transforming this current source. You can think of transforming this voltage source. Now, when both current source and voltage source can be transformed, which one would you go for? Which one would you go for? See here. First, before transformation, you need to look at whether these sources can be transformed or not. Okay, when can sources be transformed? As we have seen earlier, a voltage source can be transformed when there is a resistor in series with that. A current source can be transformed when there is a resistor in parallel with that. Okay, is that the case here? Yes, that is the case. We have a resistor in parallel with the current source, so this can be transformed. There is a resistor in series with the old, so this can also be transformed. But that doesn't mean that we should transform both. Okay, we're not transforming 50 volt source because we want this to be there, because we are asked to find out the power delivered by 50 volt source, by source transformation. So this branch I'm not touching. You can rather go with this or go with this. Fine. So by experience, what we can understand is transforming this into a current source would reduce the size of the network. Why the source transformation is important? this source transformation is important from the point that the circuit size would get reduced, and that's why the solution would be a simple one. Fine. So if you have to think of that, then you should see that this has to be transformed into a current source. So that means you will have a current source in parallel with these two, and this 3 ohm will also come in parallel with these two. So when this 3 ohm comes in parallel with 2 amperes, that you can combine. And when this voltage source comes in parallel with this current source, this voltage source becomes a current source, right? That comes in parallel with this. I'll write that, you'll just understand. What happens if I transform this current source? What happens if I transform this voltage source? Okay, so transforming this current source will not help us. You can try do that and see. But transforming this voltage source into a current source would help reduce the size of the network. So what I'm doing is transforming. This is not ohms, mind you. So this is not ohms. Okay, so that's volts. So transforming 10 volt source. So that means we are transforming 10 volt source into a current source. So how our circuit would look like? See here, this would not change because we are not transforming 50 volts. Similarly, this would not change because we are not touching upon the current source. Fine. What happens? Let's write what all these are. This is 50 volt source. This is 5 ohms. This is 10 amperes flowing upwards. And this is 2 ohms. So what happened to me? This is 2 ohms. Okay, now what's happening with this voltage source? This voltage source would now become a current source, and the resistor 3 ohms would come in parallel with that current source. Everybody just observe here. This is how the circuit looks like. Now this is the current source. Where should be the transformed current source? So the current source should be having the direction like this, because plus is at the top. So my current would be flowing upwards. Fine. So arrowhead would be at the top. Understand this, everybody? Now, everybody just observe. What would this current be? This is 3 ohms in parallel with the current source. What is this current source? Okay. So what is I? I is equal to V by R. So what is V by R? V by R is 10 by 3. Let's write it as 10 by 3 amps only. So this is how it looks like. Fine. You have 10 by 3 amperes current source in parallel with this 10 ohms. So 10 by 3 plus 10 is what these two would become, because both are flowing upwards. So current sources in parallel would get added up. Fine. And similarly, we can see what is the equivalent resistance of 2 ohms and 3 ohms, because they are in parallel. Understand? So what would this circuit look like now? So this circuit would look like this branch. Anyways, I'm not touching upon, because I'm not ready to lose 50 volts. Instead, I'll be working with the other two branches. So circuit finally reduces to this. What is this? 50 volts would be there as it is. Fine. So this is 5 ohms. Okay, what is this flowing upwards? It is 10 plus 10 by 3. What is this? This is 2 parallel 3. What is 2 parallel 3? It's 2 into 3 divided by 2 plus 3. Okay, so how it would look like? How it would look like is the question. So what is this current source going to be? What is this current source? So this would be 40 by 3. Okay. And this would be 6 by 5. So therefore, what we have is this. So further, what we have is this. Okay, I'll just write down the circuit again. So what I have now is this. This is 50 volts, 5 ohms, okay? This is 40 by 3 amps, and this is 6 by 5 ohms. Understand this? Now what we can do? Now what we can do further? So we have to find out the power delivered by this. Okay, so we need to know what is the current that is flowing through this. So that we shall do, but before that, let's again transform this into a voltage source so that we can have just one closed path. There are two closed paths now. Okay, so let's not get into this. Let's make it a circuit having one closed path. So if you want to have a circuit with one closed path, what you can do, you can transform this back to voltage source. Okay, so transforming 40 by 3. What is that? Transforming 40 by 3 to voltage source. So what happens, everybody write that? We are transforming the current source back. So how it would look like? It would look like this: 5 ohms, 50 volts. We have not manipulated. Rather, we'll be having a voltage source and a resistor in series. So this is how it is going to look like. Now, so what would this be? This would be a voltage source plus at the top, because the current source is moving up, the current is moving upwards, and this is 6 by 5. So what would this voltage source be? V is equal to IR. What is I? I is 40 by 3, R is 6 by 5. So what would that be? It would be 16 volts. Okay, so this is 16 volts, and this is 1.2 ohms. So this is how things look like. Fine. So since we have to find out the power delivered by, 50 volts, so what we need to do? We need to have V into I. V is known. What is V? V is 50. Okay. Where is I? You can mark I. Okay. How we can mark I? I can mark my I like this. This is my I. Why like that? Because the voltage source has plus at the top, right? That's why my arrowhead I want at the top. So this current would be flowing throughout the circuit. So apply KVL. Why we have to apply KVL now? Because I want to find out this current. Because if I know the current, then I can know the power delivered by 50 volt source. So let's find out the current I. To find current I, what we do? To find I, apply KVL. How does it look like? Minus 50 plus 5i plus 16 plus 1.2i equal to 0. Okay, so our I would be 5.48 amps. This implies that our I is 5.48 48 amps. Therefore, I can have my power delivered by 50 volt source as what is that? It's V into I, right? V is 50, I is 5.48. So therefore, power delivered by 50 volt source would be what? It would be 274. Just take, you know, I have to calculate, just get to understand the method of doing it. See, everybody, when we are asked to find out the power delivered by voltage source or current source, you need to deal with V into I only. In the internals, most of you have dealt with I squared R stuff. No. R is not to be seen here. With this, you have to see it's V into I only. R is in series with this, mind you. Okay, and this 50 volts is not across 5 ohms. So you cannot bring in 5 ohm, you cannot bring in R when you are finding out power delivered by a voltage source or a current source. When you are dealing with the power dissipated by the resistor, then you can deal with I squared R. Understand that. So that mistake you have done in the internals. Always, when you are trying to find out the power delivered by voltage source or the current source, it should always be V into I only. It cannot be I squared R, because R is not 5 ohms, mind you. Okay. So we have to have 50 volts and the current flowing through that, mind you. Okay. Fine then. So this is how it looks like. So what is the advantage of the source transformation? See, if you have to deal with the same by mesh analysis or node analysis, in mesh analysis, how we can solve? See, there are three meshes. You can form a super mesh. There are three meshes. You can form a super mesh. How many KVL problem it would be? It would be three KVL problem. One KVL to the super mesh, another KVL to mesh three. Okay. And one more equation you'll get by the constraint equation. That is how we can solve this problem by mesh analysis. By node analysis, how can we solve? We can solve this by node analysis. Okay. By marking the node voltage. How many node voltages are there? There's just one node voltage, because there's just one node. So this is ground. Fine. And apply KCL at this particular node. That's it. This is how you find out power delivered by 50 volt by node analysis. So you can solve the same problem by mesh analysis and node analysis, but see that you would get the same power, okay, delivered by the 50 volt source. So you can take that as an exercise. Solve the same problem. Solve problem three. Okay. Solve exercise. By mesh and node analysis also. This is the exercise that you should do. Why you should do this by other methods also? See, if you can get it by mesh analysis and node analysis, your confidence will be boosting. Okay, so if you can solve this by any method, you would really be very confident when it comes to solve any problem. That's why I'm giving you that exercise. And this is what is the advantage of source transformation. See, in source transformation, we are bringing the circuit to the simplest form possible. Or in other words, we can reduce the size of the circuit given. How many meshes were there? One, two, three meshes were there. From three mesh problem, it has become one mesh problem. So source transformation helps us in reducing the size of the circuit given. Understand that? So this is what I had to give you about source transformation. Now we shall see another concept called source shifting. Everybody take that. We shall take another method called, it's not method, it's the extension of source transformation. Okay, that we shall do now. So let's take this as source shifting. What we have seen so far is source transformation. Okay, source shifting is something that we have to do as an extension of source transformation. When we will go for source shifting, you will understand. Okay, as of now, let's see what is source shifting. Then we shall see how it can be the extension of source transformation and why we have to go for shifting. You'll understand. Fine. Transformation is what? Transformation is transforming, converting the voltage source into current source, or current source into voltage source. For that to be done, voltage source should have a series resistance, or current source should have a parallel resistance. Then only the conversion of current into voltage or voltage into current is possible. So what is shifting? As the name suggests, it's shifting of the source. It's not conversion of sources into current or voltage. It is shifting of sources from one place to another. Get that point? So let's understand that now. Everybody, just take down this. Voltage shifting. What we are doing is voltage source shifting. Everybody copy this. Voltage source shifting. Fine. Everybody just concentrate here. What we are doing is this. Suppose you have two resistors like this. So you have a resistor here, you have another resistor here. Fine. Then suppose you have a voltage source here, and this is some terminal. Suppose you have a circuit like this across terminals AB, and say this is plus or minus some voltage V. Okay, and you have the resistors R1 and R2. So this is how the network is, or the circuit is. Now the question to you is, can we transform this voltage? So what we are discussing is source shifting. So we are trying to see how the voltage source can be shifted. Okay. So before that, let me ask you this. Can we transform this voltage source? Anybody would like to answer that? Can we transform this voltage source is the question. Anybody would like to answer that? When can we transform a voltage source? When can we transform a voltage source? Pavan, EC67, register number 67, you are there. Pavan, can you unmute yourself? There is a voltage source, but these two resistances are not actually in series with this. If you combine these two, yes. But as it is, you cannot say the combination of R1, R2, the parallel combination of R1, R2 are in series with this, but not any resistor directly in series with this. So what we can do in that case, everybody observe here. Okay. So this end of R1 is connected to the positive polarity. This end of R2 is connected to the positive polarity, but the B is connected. Terminal B is connected to the negative polarity. So keeping this condition in mind, what we can do is we can do this. See, everybody observe. We can shift. How I can shift? See here. Let my R1 be there. Okay. We can bring in this voltage source. So let R2 be there. Okay. So I can bring in the voltage source. This is how the circuit is going to look like now. what happened? Earlier there were two resistors, okay, R1 and R2, but these R1 and R2 were not in series with the voltage source. But so what did we do? We did this. We brought in this voltage source in both the branches. So this is positive. So this is what is called as source shifting. What are the conditions that need to be kept in mind or fulfilled? See, this end of R1 is with positive polarity of V. This end of R2 is with positive polarity of V, that is there. And this B is with negative polarity. Everybody understand? So this is possible. So what happened? What is the advantage of shifting now? So see, in the given network, this transformation is not possible as it is. The transformation is not possible as it is. Since transformation is not possible, you can think of shifting so that the transformation becomes possible. Everybody understand that? Why do we go for source shifting? We go for source shifting when the transformation is not possible. So shift it in such a way that the transformation of sources would become possible. Everybody understand that? So take down this. Those who have not given the attendance, you can give it now. So let's go with another way. So if the circuit is given like this, let me write this, okay? So instead of, let's say this, fine. Then you have these. So you have R1, R2, R3, and you have V. Okay, so if there is a circuit like this, what you would do? A, B, C, this is how the circuit is. So can you transform it yourself now? Can you first shift so that the transformation becomes possible? So here also, since R1, R2, R3 are not in series with V, but they are, what's happening? So they're neither in parallel. R1, R2, R3 are not in parallel, whereas R1 and R2 were in parallel here in this case. Here they are not in parallel because these ends are not connected. The other ends are not connected. Okay, so this. There is some network that follows this. Fine. So for this to be possible to be transformed into a current, so there should be a resistor here. Okay. So what we can do for transformation to be possible, you have to shift it. Shift this into these places. Everybody do that. Okay. So I can shift. Suppose you have, if you have three branches, you'll have the voltage source in three numbers. So this is how the things look like. This is A, B, C, D, R1, R2, R3 would not change. Okay. Now which polarity should come where? See, this A is connected to positive polarity. So for this has to be positive. Means first you need to have positive sign. So anyway, this would be negative. So plus, minus, plus, minus. See, with the voltage source now, there are resistors in series. So these voltage sources can now be transformed into current sources. Everybody understand this point? Similarly, we can transform, we can shift current sources also. Okay, everybody take down this. Everybody copy this down. Current source shifting. Current source shifting. So how can we shift the current source now? You have seen the example of voltage shifting. We shall see the example of current shifting. Fine. Suppose there are resistors like this. Fine. Say there are resistors R1 and R2, okay, and there is a current source here. Fine. Now again, as we asked the question earlier, can we transform this current source into voltage source is the question that you need to answer. Can we transform this current source into voltage source? No, because the resistors are not in parallel for the parallel with this. When can I say there is a resistor in parallel? When you have a resistor connected with these two points. So what I can do, say this is A, B, and C. Where is current I flowing? Current I is flowing from A to C, right? So what I can do is this. So you have A, B, C, right? So now what I can do is here. So this is possible. Why this is possible? Everybody understand this. Earlier, what was happening? The current was flowing from A to C, but this current source was in such a way that this cannot be transformed into a voltage source because there is no resistor in parallel with this. So what did I do? I brought this current source with in parallel with R1 as well as R2. Why is that possible? This is open circuit. Open circuit means the current that flows from A to B. Do you think that would flow through this circuit? No, in this path, this will not flow because it is open circuit. Okay. So whatever current that we have connected from A to B will go from A to B. And since there is no path in this direction, okay, the same current can flow through this. So it's the same current that is flowing from A to C. But first it goes to B and from B it comes to C, whereas it was going from A to C directly. So we are increasing the number of sources. But ultimately, if you see, the circuit size would decrease. Ultimately, the circuit size would decrease. For circuit size to be decreased, you need to have source transformation possible. But as it is, the source transformation is not possible. So shift the current source in such a way that the source transformation would become possible. Understand that? We shall take a problem on this and we shall solve that. Then you will understand the importance of source shifting. Fine. We will connect again in the next session.